Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you ways to fix the connected no internet error on your PC in Windows 10 or Windows 11. I'll be showing you within Windows 11, but most of the methods will be nearly identical in Windows 10 as well. Let's get into them. We'll start with some basic fixes, so feel free to use the chapters to skip past anything you've already tried. Firstly, I'd recommend testing your network connection on another device, such as your phone. If there's an issue on that too, then you know the problem relates to your router, so you might want to power it off and then power it on again, and if it still doesn't work, try contacting your internet service provider or check the service status. Next, we can try reconnecting to the Wi-Fi network. If you have a wired connection, then unplug the cable, wait a few seconds, and then reconnect. But to reconnect to Wi-Fi, first we need to forget the Wi-Fi network, so open the main settings app, and then look for the option called Network and Internet from the menu on the left, and click on it, and then choose Wi-Fi. On this page, look for your current Wi-Fi network. You might need to click on where it says Manage Known Networks. Click on Forget. You may need to click on the three dots icon to see this option, and you may also need to confirm this. Once the network disappears from the list, head back and find the Available Networks section. Find your network from the list and click on it. Enter the password correctly and connect to the network. Then test out your connection. If the problem is still here, then we'll move on. The next method will be to run the automatic network troubleshooter, just to see if Windows can find any fixes for the problem. Open the Settings app and then choose System from the left, and now scroll down and click on Troubleshoot. If you don't see the list of troubleshooters, click on where it says Other Troubleshooters and look for the one called Network and Internet. Click on Run next to this and then allow this to complete. If Windows recommends any fixes, try these. If not, we can move on. We'll now run some commands to reset various network settings. The DNS flush command we'll try first has fixed this issue for me in the past. To do this, we need to head to the command prompt. You can get here by searching for it in the search bar, but before opening it, you will need to right-click on it and then select Run as Administrator. When it opens, we need to input some specific text. I will include this in the description if you want to copy and paste it. First, type in ipconfig space forward slash flushdns and press enter. After this completes, test your connection again to see if this has fixed it. As mentioned, this has worked for me in the past, so give it a minute or two to see if this has helped. If not, we have a few more commands to try. Next, type in netsh, then space, then int, space ip, space reset. Press the enter key to run this command. The next command to enter is ipconfig space forward slash release. Press enter again to run this one. Now type in ipconfig space forward slash renew and then press enter. Now is a good time to restart your PC to see if any of these commands have fixed the problem. The next few methods will be in the device manager, so search for this in the search bar and open it. Within it, expand the section called network adapters and find yours from the list. If you're not sure which yours is, then you can try the following methods for each of them, but it will probably have words like LAN, Wi-Fi or network adapter in the name. First, right-click on your network adapter and then choose Update Driver. Choose the automatic option and see if there's any driver updates. You could also check for and then download and install driver updates from the manufacturer's website. Use the name and model number of your adapter here to search for the correct download page, but this will differ with each manufacturer. If your network adapter is on your motherboard, then your motherboard's support page should also have the drivers. If there weren't any driver updates, close this box, and then right-click on your network adapter again, and this time choose Properties. In the Advanced tab, you could try some of the other settings in here for the categories, and test these out to see if it makes a difference. I'd only recommend doing this if you know what the categories mean. If this didn't help, make sure you set them back to how they were. Next, click on the Power Management tab if you have it, and then turn off the top toggle switch called Allow the Computer to Turn Off This Device to Save Power, and click on OK to test this out. Finally, we can try disabling the device and then re-enabling it. Right-click on the network adapter, and choose Disable Device from the list, then choose Yes. Wait a few seconds, right-click on it again, and choose Enable Device, and wait a few more seconds, and test your connection. You could also try uninstalling the device. To do this, right-click on it, and choose Uninstall Device, then uninstall. Now go to where it says Action at the top, and choose Scan for Hardware Changes. Then wait a while and test your connection. You may need to restart your PC if your network adapter doesn't show up. The next method will be to reset the general network settings in Windows. You might need to do some setup after this method, so you could leave it until last. For example, you'll need to reconnect to your Wi-Fi network again. To reset the network settings, open the main settings app and search for Network Reset. You can also get here by choosing Network and Internet, Advanced Network Settings, and then Network Reset. On this page, read the information on here, and then choose Reset Now when you're ready, as your PC will need to restart, and you'll need to set up your networks. Next, think about any network-related software such as VPNs or antivirus. If you have these, try temporarily disabling them to see if this fixes the problem. The next methods will relate to your firewall. We can try and see if this was causing the problem. Search for Windows Security in the search bar and open this app. Within it, look for the option called Firewall and Network Protection and open this page. Firstly, click on where it says Allow an app through the firewall, and if you have any network-related apps, such as a VPN, make sure the boxes are checked for this app, especially for private networks. You'll need to click on where it says Change Settings to edit this, and if you're not sure about making any changes, then leave this for now, and click on OK or Cancel to exit. Stay in the firewall settings, and you could temporarily disable the firewall, but only while we test it. To do this, click on where it says Private Networks and use the toggle switch to disable it. Try your connection now and see if this helped. Turn this toggle switch back on before you leave this page. Head back a page, and there's one more thing we can try in the firewall settings. Find where it says Restore Firewalls to Default, and click on this. Now choose Restore Defaults, confirm this, and wait a few seconds and try your connection now. Some apps might stop working, and you'll need to restart them, and maybe even your PC after this. Next, as a temporary solution, you could try a USB Wi-Fi adapter. These won't cost much and will hopefully allow you to connect to the internet if you think the issue is related to a hardware fault. To conclude the video, I'll mention a few more fixes you could try, but they are slightly more advanced, and you'll probably want to research more into them to make your mind up on whether you want to try them. Firstly, you might want to check in the BIOS that the network adapter is definitely set to enabled. The method to do this may vary slightly, so you'll probably want to look up your exact BIOS version to check, but it will likely be in an advanced settings section or integrated peripherals or onboard devices. This probably won't fix the issue, as it's unlikely to work at all if it was disabled, but it's worth checking. Next, you could potentially factory reset your PC or laptop if you think that the issue is software related or caused by Windows itself. You will need to make sure everything is backed up before doing this. Finally, there's always the chance that the problem is caused by faulty hardware, so you could replace the component, install a new one, or take your PC or laptop to a repair shop. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. As always, I'll keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine, showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Windows PC. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.